What you doing, Daily Dreamers? You got Mathras back for the GLA Finals. This is the VDL versus the UBA, myself versus Malcolm24. This is it. The VDL wins this one, they win it all. The UBA wins, they win it all. Now, obviously not. I think my battle was the first battle that actually took place, so it was only, you know, not like if I won, we won, or if I lost, we lost, or anything. But, you know, one of seven battles, and I'd love to chalk it up for a win. Anyway, my opponent had a very interesting team. It was very slow in general. I think the fastest thing he had was a Volcarona, which he didn't even bring. So I was able to bring Adamant Cinderace, which I thought was pretty fun. I brought a couple, like I had Adamant, this thing, Obstagoon. I had Modest Noivern. So a lot of really cool options here. Oh, I did it again. Hold on. But what I realized pretty early on was that Jellicent was a bit of a threat. So I needed Obstagoon in. I knew I could come in because I don't mind a Scald Burn and like Shadow Ball I'm immune to. I wanted that Clefable, so I just went for the Facade. But now I can now taunt the Celesteela as that comes in. My favorite thing to do. I want somebody to count how many times I taunted a Celesteela in the GLA. Heavy Slam does a lot though, and Knock Off is not going to be knocking this thing out, so I'm forced to switch into Corviknight. Thankfully taking that Heavy Slam, and I can also taunt this thing again if I need to, which I think I do. Yeah. So that's two already in this battle. And now my opponent's starting to get a little wise to my act. And Flamethrower is doing a good amount, but not enough, especially since I have Roost. As he goes Zatu there, and I bulk up again. So yeah, Zatu is in. He's got Haze, which is pretty sad. And of course, my Brave Bird's not doing enough, and he's Rocky Helmet. So very sad, very sad. As he Roosts up, I think I also Roost up. Yeah, just double Roost. I just go for a bulk up again as he actually teleports. So I was like, okay, you know what? He's probably going to switch. As he just doubles back into Zatu, and I go for the Brave Bird, which doesn't 2-hit KO, unfortunately. So I'm taking a little Rocky Helmet. He Roosts, and I just go for the Brave Bird again, and it does do over half, but it doesn't look like I'm outspeeding. So unfortunately, he gets the Haze off, and I'm just Roosting. I figured the Haze was coming there. I just wanted to get some HP back, and he Roosts again. I'm just playing like mind games with here, trying to see what he does. Oh yeah, and I disconnected a bunch of times because I was playing on my laptop, which doesn't have a great internet connection here. But I get Obstagoon in on the Haze, get the Switcheroo off, which I was very excited about, able to Switcheroo the Flame Orb onto the Celesteela, but then, you know, he gets the Leech Seed off, so I probably should have taunted or something. I just wanted the KO, I wanted blood. But I get Nidoqueen in on the Protect, and he switches to Zatu, so I get a Flamethrower off, which does a lot, and I actually am fast enough to outspeed this thing, and I knock it out with an Ice Beam, so cool. Jellicent comes in though, big threat. I go Obstagoon hoping that he goes for like a Will-O-Wisp or something, but no, it just knocks me out. Unfortunately, Obstagoon goes down. It was probably one of my best things to take on Jellicent, and I could have hit the Metagross really hard too, so I probably should have played a little more safe with the Obstagoon, but I was just happy to get the Switcheroo off, honestly. So he makes a good play there with the Earthquake, taking my Nidoqueen down to 19%, which is not bad. Which is bad, but obviously I can hit him with a Flamethrower. I would have knocked him out, but instead he sacks his Celesteela. So at this point, my Gardevoir is basically my main switch into his Jellicent, and I have to, you know, I can't click Hyper Voice. It hits the Jellicent obviously with Thunderbolt, and hits the Metagross harder than that too. and I was actually purposely showing Hyper Voice here because I know he had a Kamoho, and I thought he might think that he was safe to come in with Kamoho versus Gardevoir, but I actually had Psychic in the back. Again, going for Thunderbolt, or no, I went for Wish, sorry. But I can now Hyper Voice, doing 50% of that Clefable as he gets a Wish off. I get a Wish off too, goes hard Metagross as I just Wish, and unfortunately the Wish passes to his Metagross, which is not great because Metagross is quickly becoming a big threat, especially as he Ice Punches there on that switch, which is, you know, pretty damn good. I still have Cinderace though, so it's not over yet. As I U-turn on the Jellicent, bring Gardevoir back in, and unfortunately his Metagross is still at 100%, so it's pretty safe to switch in. I'm doing a good chunk with this, but he's got leftovers, and I'm not getting a paralyzation. I don't know, that's the only thing that maybe could have saved me. So he doubles there into Jellicent on the Corviknight, which I can taunt, but I don't want to because I don't want to get Scald Burned as he Magic Coats, which would have been pretty fire. He brings the Kamo in finally, thinks he's safe, and I just obliterate him with a Psychic. So now he goes into Metagross, obviously threatening out my Gardevoir. But I get Corviknight in, I'm like, okay, Corviknight might be the only thing that can take this on at this point. So I get the taunt off, knowing that he's going to go one of these two, and it is Jellicent. So I get the taunt off, Gardevoir as he doubles into Metagross, good play. I go Corviknight, I have to, is the only thing that can maybe take a hit, as he does reveal the Thunder Punch, which does I can roost it off, but it's not great. So I go for the taunt, thinking he's going to switch. And I'm in a bad spot now, because my Corviknight is 2 KO'd by Thunder Punch now, and as my Nidoqueen is unfortunately sacked. I've got to, something's got to give here. I go for the Thunderbolt, it's not enough. And I think here is when I try to make the play, but he makes the better play by just Meteor Mashing and knocking me out. Basically the play I was hoping for there was that he would go for any move other than Meteor Mash, and I would be able to live it, and then, you know, outspeed the following turn, as he's revealed to not have Bullet Punch, and then maybe knock him out. But it looks like with leftovers, I probably wouldn't have anyway. So, yeah. If I had gone Corviknight there, maybe the Meteor Mash would have done enough to the point where Thunder Punch on the following turn would have knocked me out. But anyway, bringing Cinderace, my last ditch chance here, as he's only doing 30% of the Jellicent, which is pretty unfortunate. But I go for the Zen Headbutt, maybe I can flinch, but I get Curse Bodied and Scalded, and nope, not yet. But I go for the Sucker Punch, fails as he recovers, very unfortunate. And then I go try for the Sucker Punch again as he Will-O-Wisps and burns me. Imagine if I had Powerballed there, it would have been great. Big side effect to Libero Cinderace is the chance to get burned. But that, I think, having Cinderace burned, that's pretty much the end of the game. And then the Scald burns Corviknight as well. So that's it. Unfortunately, did not come through for my team in the final hour. I try to bulk up with Corviknight here, but I'm not doing it, as he does have the Flamethrower. I think I might be able to knock out his Clefable here with the Pyro Ball, even though I'm burned. But I'm definitely not knocking out Jellicent anytime soon. I get Curse Bodied again, which probably was my only chance, if I could Zen Headbutt flinch him all the way down, and then maybe Pyro Ball. Yeah, Pyro Ball probably would have knocked out Metagross at 39%, so it wasn't over, but it was not, I would need a lot of luck. So, very well played to my opponent in the beginning. And then got a little bit lucky. He got a little bit lucky, but he played well. And I think we both played well. It was a fun game. And unfortunately, lost for my team in the finals of the GLA. And the UBA Malcolm 24 team did go on to win the finals, unfortunately. So the VDL got second place. Pretty proud of that. I think I played really well in a lot of these games. I didn't win as much of them as I would have liked to, but I think I played well, prepped well, and learned a lot. So, looking forward to the next season, seeing if the VDL can pull something crazy off. So, see you guys in the next one. Peace out. Keep dreaming. Goodbye.